I've just filed a flight plan of visual flight from Watertown, South Dakota to Sioux City, Iowa. I've just received ATIS. Take me a minute to get this set up. Okay. Active runway is 30 and altimeter is 3021. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey radio check.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, you are loud and clear.
Open flight plan from Kilo Alpha Tango Yankee to Kilo Sierra Uniform X-ray for Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, flight plan activated at altimeter at Watertown Regional is 3021.
Okay. And then when I get up in the air, I'll ask for flight following. I don't know if that's what they usually do, but so they, I mean pilots. Okay, taxi lights. I guess I should get my radios going first. Okay, let's take a look here. The Sioux Falls VOR is 1150. The Watertown has one, and it is 116.6, and Sioux City has one. KSUX 116.5. Okay. Put in the Watertown first. Because I probably might be able to pick up the Sioux City one, but I'm not sure. Yep. Okay, let's put in Sioux Falls. Okay, the heading of the runway is 30. Okay. This is runway 30. There's no ground or tower here, so I need to get that down there to there. Watertown, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, taxiing to runway 30, Watertown. Okay, it's going to be take a little bit of time. We'll be crossing over a runway. Looks like there's something right in front of us. Nope, there's trees. Watertown, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, crossing runway 17, Watertown. Down a little bit.
And one Charlie Alpha is on attack here.
One Charlie Alpha, Roger. You can plan for a left turn at the Sierra.
Looks right, one Charlie Alpha.
Landing lights, taxi lights off, strobe on, flaps good, flight director needs to be on. Toga on, heading bug on.
What's your first heading to Lima Yankee Victor? It'll be a probably a 005. 005, thank you, sir.
And we will head to the south. Okay. Watertown, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, ready for departure, runway 30, departing to the south, Watertown. We'll be taking off over the lake.
Zero,
gear up. Back on the props. This is a left-hand turn. Get out over the lake a little bit. We'll turn to the south-southeast. Picking up Sioux Falls, that's good. Turn off the landing lights. Oh, and that's there we go. Okay. Heading bug. Autopilot on. Nav 2 speaker off. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey climbing through 5,000 feet.
1 Mike Whiskey, good morning. Squawk 1200 altimeter 3021.
Squawk 1200 altimeter 3021, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. I don't know why my have to check that. Let's see here. Why isn't it coming to the front? Altitude hold. Oh, something happened. That's too bad. Active. Okay. I need to descend a little bit. I'll request flight following here in a minute.
240, we're clear on 18 Delta, we're going to drive up. 240, we're going to take Fox 3. Fox 3 to the ramp.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey requesting flight following from Kilo Alpha Tango Yankee to Kilo Sierra Uniform X-ray at 6,500 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey continue to maintain VFR separation squawk 5553. Advise me of any altitude changes and standby for traffic advisories. Roger.
Squawk 5553, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey radar contact.
Okay, we're good. Put it on nav. I think these red things are wind generators. There's a lake down here. Let's take a look. So we are about 60 miles south of, or north of Sioux Falls. It might be Lake Poinsett passing over. Brookings will be off to our left. That's Brookings. Would be Brookings, South Dakota. Make sure everything's ship shape. Kind of ruins our night vision, but I've been practicing VFR flying from
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey for continued VFR advisories. Contact Minneapolis Center on 126.25. Enjoy your morning.
Center on 126.25, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey at 6,500 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, good morning. Radar contact. Altimeter 3023.
Altimeter 3023, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Now, using the flights, Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 ATC, they'll update with a new proper barometric pressure, but they don't have where you need to respond to it. I don't know which is right. I don't know if you're supposed to respond or not. I mean, you know, acknowledge. South Dakota State University there. I attended that college. Take a look from the outside for just a moment. So we're on our way to Sioux City. We'll be passing right over Sioux Falls, Joe Foss Field. And then continuing straight south, or straight to Sioux City. Now this time I really hope that I remember to cancel the flight plan once I'm on the ground. I have yet to remember to do that. Now, of course, if I file an IFR or with Pilot2ATC, once I land, the flight plan is automatically canceled, but not with a VFR flight plan. So, there's a town over here. Which town would that be? Madison. And there should be lakes, some lakes over there as well. This is just stunning. I just can't get enough of this. I have an infinite amount of fuel. I mean, not in this airplane, but no fuel costs. I don't have to worry about crashing. I don't have to worry about maintenance on the airplane. Just fly. Now, I would assume off in the distance there to the left is Sioux Falls. Sun's starting to come up a little bit. It's Saturday morning. This is Labor Day weekend, 2002. I had just started practicing VFR flights using Pilot2ATC on X-Plane 11 when the Microsoft Flight Sim 2020 came out, and I have to say that this flight sim, this new flight sim, makes it a lot easier to do that. I'm not very good at it, but what I have problems with is entering the pattern to make a landing on a runway. I get disoriented sometimes. It has nothing to do with this software program, because it's doing a great job. So we are 30 miles northwest of Sioux Falls. A few cars down there. One of those street lamps. I don't see any cars. Wonder if I need to change that setting. But it's pretty early in the morning. Maybe there'll be some cars over in Sioux Falls. If not, I'll turn up the number of vehicles to display. So there should be a lake to our right. Oh, so that would be Lake Madison and Brant Lake. See it right through there. Right there. So, Sioux Falls. See, the airport is right on the north edge of town, just south of I-90. Here's the intersection of I-29 and I-90. And we'll be, I do have that tuned in, so. That's going right over this end of the runway. There's a Rocky right there. Let me see if I can get that tuned in. I need to practice trying to get ADF. What was it again? 245. See why I need practice. Okay. Oops. So yep, there's 245 right there. We'll turn the ADF on, see if we can pick that up. Yep, we've got it. Cool. When I switched accidentally the navigation CDI, I guess navigation uncoupled, so I'll have to remember that. Now Sioux City is 116.5. Cross over that VOR. I'm gonna put it on heading bug. I'm going to try. I'm going to see if it stays the course or how it handles this crossing over. Now with the B-58, it continues right on, and the course indicator doesn't change. It doesn't flip. I mean, it does acknowledge that it doesn't have a signal, but it doesn't flip. Let's see if this flips or what. Five miles out from FSD. Miles. And keep an eye on that indicator. This one. See see how it handles the loss of signal and then crossing over. Seems to be handling it okay. No, it's turning. Heading bug. Looks like we're picking the signal back up. In Sioux Falls, there's the airport, there's Joe Foss Field. See any cars. I don't know if they have that active yet. I know they've got the weather throttled back some, seems like. They're bringing stuff on in stages, I suppose. So, looks like the nav is still going okay. We're going to turn that back on. And we're good. We'll just follow that until we pick up Sioux City VOR. Six, I don't have that right. Let's see here. Okay.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey for continued VFR advisories. Contact Minneapolis Center on 125.02. Enjoy your morning.
Center on 125.02, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey at 6,500 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, good morning. Radar contact, altimeter 3022.
Altimeter 3022, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. So the next town of any significance, Canton will be off to our left, Beersford. Okay, there's a lot of little towns. See if there's another ADF we can call up so I can practice that. I know there's one in Sioux City. Tommy, no, yeah, Tommy, 305. Should see a lot of wind generators. 305 for Tommy. Oh, we're picking up Sioux City, good. Turn on heading bug. Switch frequencies. Line up on that. And go back to nav. So ADF would be 305. So we have the Tommy ADF frequency ready. So how far out are we? 60 miles. Start descending here pretty soon. I think I can see the lights clear in the distance. we should be able to cross over the Big Sioux River. Baron 1, Baron 1, Mike Whiskey descending to 5,500 feet.
Baron 1, Mike Whiskey, roger.
Here we go, 5,400. Oops, missed it. What did I push? Pushed heading by mistake. There's Interstate 29. Think. Say active runway at Kilo Sierra Uniform X-ray for Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey arriving and departing runway 34. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey contact Sioux City approach on 124.6. Enjoy your morning.
Contact approach on 124.6, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey at 5,500 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, good morning. Radar contact. Expect runway 31.
31. Expect runway 31, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. I'm going to descend. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey descending to 4,500 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, roger.
Need to get up the airfield. Runway 31. See if I can do this better this time. Baron, one Mike Whiskey, 30 miles north of Sioux City, requesting vectors for a straight-in approach to runway 31. Baron, one Mike Whiskey.
Baron, one Mike Whiskey, roger, radar contact. Turn left heading 146 vectors to the straight in approach for runway 31 at Sioux Gateway Brick General Day Altimeter 3021. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, climb and maintain 7,000 feet.
Whoa, okay. Climb and maintain 7,000 feet, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Turn left heading.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, expedite climb to 7,000 feet.
Expedite climb to 7,000 feet, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Heading is 146. The altimeter was 3021. Sure glad this aircraft has the power. Now I just need to upgrade my GPU. See what happens, huh? Big planet up there above us. I gotta get this thing on the ground so I can go to the grocery store. I gotta get donuts. It's Saturday morning. It's stay home day and the girls expect donuts.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, turn right heading 151.
Heading 151, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, turn left heading 146.
Heading 146, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Guess I'm just, you gotta have one of them up. Here's the Missouri River. There. There's the airport we're going to be landing on. I believe this is the runway. That's runway 31. Because this would be runway 34. I can see that these are not an accurate representation of the actual runways. They're just symbols. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey requesting new altitude of 5,000 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, descend and maintain 6,500 feet.
Descend and maintain 6,500 feet, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Okay, 6,500 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, descend and maintain 3,900 feet.
Descend and maintain 3,900 feet, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Must have had me climb to 7,000 because I was entering Class C airspace. I don't know, but I have grown to trust Pilot2ATC. It does well.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, turn right heading 223.
Right heading 223, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. trying to get it down to 3,900 feet. Right there. Okay, so where are we? Here it is, we're getting lined up. Might as well turn on my landing lights. Oops.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, turn right heading 282, cleared for visual straight in approach runway 31, contact tower on 118.7. Good morning.
Turn right heading 282, contact tower on 118.7. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey at 3,900 feet.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, good morning. Radar contact. Maintain heading 282.
Maintain heading 282, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, you were garbled. Please say again.
Maintain heading, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, turn right heading 312, continue approach. Runway is 13 nautical miles, call field in sight.
Turn to heading 312, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, field in sight.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, roger, winds are light and variable, cleared to land runway 31.
Cleared to land runway 31, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. My landing lights are on. Laps down one. We'll exit to the right.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, you have traffic at 12 o'clock 6 miles at 1,100 feet.
I don't see anything. Oh yeah, I do. Traffic insight, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Crossing over the Missouri. No. No, we're not. It's I-29 down. Good thing I checked. There's that aircraft. Just took off runway 34.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, exit runway when able.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, roger. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, clear of active.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, welcome to Sioux Gateway Brig General Day contact ground on 121.9er. Have a good morning.
Ground on 121.9er, Baron 1 Mike Whiskey. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey requesting taxi instructions to General Aviation Parking.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, taxi to General Aviation Parking via taxiways Alpha, Delta, hold short runway 35.
Taxi to General Aviation Parking via taxiways Alpha, Delta, hold short runway 35. Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.
Baron 1 Mike Whiskey, taxi to General Aviation Parking.
Okay, so there's some fluttering going on, but let's see. So if I pull this up, so I think I'm here actually. So Delta, oh, it wants me to go. I may be no, here. So keep going. Okay. Not sure. I'm going to go straight ahead. If there's a runway, I will stop. So this is the hard part. Finding where I'm supposed to go. This is the terminal. There's also General Aviation Parking over here. The ground crew over here. Now my graphics card just can't handle all this. I park it right here. Okay. Brake. Avionics off. Mixture off. Cowling flaps up. Fuel off. Alternators off. Lights off. Okay. So, sorry about all that flickering, but I made it. So, thanks for flying along with Baron 1 Mike Whiskey.